The images of this presentation were created in 2003 using Bryce software. They were made to tell the story of where our dependence on oil is going to lead. After many years of burning fossil fuels indiscriminately, the skies became gray all over the planet. The dreams were diminished, almost gone. When the dancers were released from the tower, they had an oxygen allotment and filter rations. They thought they were free. Each had come from inside and had knowledge from the data in the tower system. Few were very old, and the wisest worked to use what was known to understand why society had forsaken the natural world. A number were young and rebellious, then angry. Food could be grown in the garden spheres, away from the chemical rain. The fortunate lived lives fed from the sheltered environments pioneered with the biosphere. Children who lived in the garden cities could watch vegetables grow and might still know hope for a while. Human life clung to the small amounts of undiscovered petroleum for needed energy to filter air and water for survival. Many life forms were extinct, the seas filled with inedible, diseased fish. Survival was finite, even with cloning. No amount of influence could bring more life. The few who prevailed in the conquest for material power in the harsh societies of the tower cities could afford to live in the light of the sun over the heavy clouds. At the top of the air towers, they faced their growing children and tried to justify continuing the isolation and separation from the people below who were struggling to breathe. The young ones knew what price was paid to bring the sun through the windows of their homes. The dancers sometimes were new, from above. Few could remain there. Work in the concrete tower was harsh, cramped. They were led to think they could return. There was no one to tell them otherwise. Feeling free, they would use their oxygen allotment for the dance around the fire. The women that came down often had children soon. Later, they would reuse their child's filter elements themselves, then place their own fresh elements in the child's mask so the child could breathe and play in the sunset light by the fire. In the morning, those who had danced would realize that they could not return to the tower. They would be angry for a while, then most would understand why civilization had lost control of itself in the ecosphere. They would understand that the truth of the human unconscious, the truth of the compulsions, was rejected too long and control was lost. Wants and desires were allowed to rule, and those with material power would not acknowledge that needs were different, sacred. Before the towers and the purified air in them, the powerful would watch their young children die in the deep, trusting love of the sacred spark of life in their innocent eyes go dark as the hopes and dreams disappear. The great towers that housed what was called a city were ruled by those descended from the original financiers. In the beginning, the biospheres used shapes that could utilize several renewable resources. Then it grew too dark. Eventually, they grew tired of defending their grown children and watched them be shut out to die when someone younger, healthier, learned how to do the needed work. Later, as their natural individuality developed, if they became lazy, indolent, rebellious, or rancorous, a judge would set them free, release them from the tower into the poisonous world below, condemned to a slow death. Banished with no preparation, not even the truth of what life had become on the ground. The sheltered children, who had only learned the warm and happy version of the world they grew into, the progress of the tower confronted their mortality.
Sick enough, they say.